Hi, my name is Tobias. In this video I demonstrate the current state of generic chem by generating and simulating the toolpath for a simple object. First I load the object by right-clicking the objects group and selecting Load Object. In the examples folder I select the half sphere. This is a sphere split in half along the z-axis. Nothing can be seen in the 3D view because most of the time the scaling of a geometry is in some odd units. Double-clicking the object opens the object editor. The current size of the object is 60×60×30 micrometers. It is probably represented by a single pixel in the middle of the 3D view. Clicking the quick scale ×10 button 3 times in a row brings the sphere to a more practical scale for CNC milling. Next, I select a workpiece and attach the sphere to it. By double clicking the workspace group, a dialog to add a workpiece opens. I select the box workspiece. It is sized a little larger than the sphere. I added to this project. By double-clicking the field in the table, the object is linked to the workpiece. Double-clicking the workpiece opens a dialog to position the objects inside the workpiece. I select the half sphere and position it to the center. I align the object with the bottom of the workpiece. Now a machine run is set up. I double-click the run group to add a machine run. Double-clicking the run itself brings up the dialog to configure the run. I select the workpiece. Next I select a machine from the machine directory and I add a tool into the machine's tool inventory. In this case a cylindrical mill with 6 mm diameter. Now the toolpath generator is set up. I select the setup generator menu item from the right-click menu. I add a new generator to the run. The area the generator will generate for is selected from the object. I select the area grid generator and set it up to generate toolpaths that overlap by 25%. I click Update and close the dialog. The toolpath is generated by selecting the Toolpath Start Generators menu item. A simulation is started by the toolpath Show Animation Control menu item. I rewind the toolpath and press play. The result is 2 cores. I go back to the toolpath generator and set the overlap to 80%. I restart the toolpath generation from the menu. The resulting toolpath is now spaced a lot closer than before. I check the result by opening the animation control again. I rewind, but this time I jump straight to the end to check the result. This toolpath I save to an NC file for transfer to a CNC machine. Inspecting the NC file with a text editor shows that a header was added with some instructions to set up the CNC machine's G-code interpreter correctly. It starts up the spindle and begins the program. In the end, it moves the tool out of the workpiece and shuts down the spindle. This program is ready to be run on a CNC machine. Thank you for watching.